Welcome back to New Day Cleveland. The rules are a lot different from when I was a kid. I'm sure you'll say the same. Did you know children must use a booster seat in the car until they are 8 years old or 4'9"? Here to talk car seat safety is Jennifer Walker from University Hospital's Rainbow Babies and Children's Hospital. Hi. Thanks for coming in.
Thanks for having me.
This is something moms at home right now, and of course myself,
need to know.
Yes, but as they grow, you have to keep getting a different car seat.
There's a lot of things to consider.
But they're important. It's like, which way do you face it? I need to know it all.
Help. All right, well, you're gonna wanna start probably when you go register.
Yes.
What most moms like is the infant carrier car seat. This is only used rear facing. The nice thing about this is the baby's asleep, you can pop it out. The base stays in the car.
And this goes in your stroller.
This can go in your stroller. A lot of them fit with travel systems. You can carry it into the store while you never have to wake the baby up, take her out of the seat. You can also buy extra bases. So if you wanna have a base for your car, base for your husband's car, base for grandma's car,
nice.
You just buy the base and then it just snaps right in.
That's perfect. So you don't have to buy three car seats.
Exactly.
How long does that face the rear?
This particular seat goes to 30 pounds. Okay. A lot of times moms give that up sooner because it's heavy. If you carry this alone, it's heavy. Plus you put the baby in there, it's pretty heavy.
Right.
So, but this particular seat, most of them go at least to 20, most of them go up to 30 pounds in this type of a carrier. So then once the baby's getting a little bit too big for this, or you're tired of carrying that around, you can move on to something like this, which is a convertible car seat.
Okay. So look at all this padding.
Yeah, so it's nice, very comfy.
Yeah.
This actually can be used rear facing up to 40 pounds. Okay. So baby's in there rear facing. Mm-hmm. When she outgrows it, then you can turn it around and use this forward facing up to 70 pounds. So the recommendation is that you keep them rear facing until 2 years old now.
2 years old?
Yeah.
What did it used to be?
It used to be 1 and 20 pounds is what a lot of people remember when I had kids. That's what it was. For the last about 2 years, it's been the AAP recommendation that they stay till they're two or until they outgrow the maximum weight of the seat. So they may even be able to stand a little bit longer, but they're safest, they're 5 times safer rear facing.
Absolutely.
When they're in a crash and you're rear facing, it protects the head and the neck, the body goes into the seat instead of, if you're forward facing in a crash, you're gonna fly forward. Baby's heads are heavy and
they don't know how to hold that up.
They can't hold the head up, the head's heavy and can cause a lot of neck and brain damage. So that's what we wanna protect.
Okay.
So they're in this until they're four.
Four? Wow.
40 pounds.
Okay.
Or actually, most of these seats, this seat goes to 70 pounds. My daughter's 9 and a half, and she's probably about that. So they're safest staying in the harness as long as possible.
Right.
Every step you take in the seats, they lose just a little bit of protection. So parents are all excited to move them to the next stage, but really you want to keep them as long as you can, because they get a little bit more protection. I mean, this is a 5-point harness. That's what race car drivers wear. I mean, it's safer than just the regular seatbelt.
That's great.
So everything's safe, but every step's a little bit less safe. So then once they're outgrowing this, then they would move to a booster seat, which these are all booster seats. So this kind of shows you the difference. They all do the same thing.
That's interesting, because this looks like it would protect more than just that.
It's really just, a lot of this is good for is if you don't have headrests in your car. So whiplash protection. So if you have a car that has a low back, that'll give you what you need to kind of protect the head and the neck. But this also comes off, so you could, a lot of these, you can use it as a high back booster, but then you can take the back off and just use it, and then it would just be something like this.
Okay.
So what this does is just positions the seatbelt across the proper parts of the body. So if you're too little and you're just using a seatbelt, that seatbelt's gonna ride up across your tummy and cause lots of damage to organs in an accident.
So once it fits right over the lap.
So once the child is 8 or 4'9", so these are all about weight. This is about height. Because it's really just about how the seatbelt fits your body. You want it across the strong parts of your body, the hip bones, so that they're protected in a crash, not across soft tissue.
Is this something new, the bubble bum?
Bubble bum, this is a neat little seat that is actually real good for travel. It's inflatable.
Okay.
It actually has really high safety standards. Rated really high on safety tests. So
it's like
good
a flotation
for an extra car. It's good for grandma's car. You know, it's good for if you're traveling. But again, these all kind of do the same thing, just positioning. They're all different styles.
Now, before I let you go, installing these is important. I think over 70% do it wrong.
So we have car seat stations at Rainbow and at Ahuja where we do that for free for people.
That's great.
And we see at least 75-80% of seats are in wrong, and that's pretty much the national average. It can be very tricky. Cars are different, the seats are different, there's different ways. You can put them in with the seatbelt, you can put it in with latch. So we recommend you get it installed, call a place like us and have them put it in.
Absolutely. Great advice from Jennifer at Rainbow. So keep that in mind. Also, we are giving away a free car seat from UH Injury Prevention Center. So all you have to do is log on to our website, fox8.com/contest, and you could win a free car seat.
Yep,
thanks to you guys.
Thanks.
Thank you so much.
Good luck.
You're awesome. Yeah, I'm going to need it. All right, from babies to teens.